How's it going, Lal?
Good, good. Long time.
Yes, you've known this gentleman for a while, haven't you?
We certainly have, since the 1980s, isn't it?
Yeah.
And we were both young.
Young and dangerous.
Dave's managed to keep his hair. Yeah. Unlike myself.
You look nice and bold for you, Dave.
Well, no, yeah, about the same as...
Cool.
That, yeah.
Yeah. So this was the design that you made, wasn't it?
Well, yeah, just because I said, yeah, we'll maybe stick something else on as well, do the dates, and I just sketched it there and then and sent it across for the crack.
Is anything as freestyle as that?
Yeah, we used to just, you know, back in the day, you'd walk in off just off the street, you could go and, you know, if you knew the tattooist, you'd go and get a tattoo, you know what I mean? You could spend it in the pub or go and get yourself scarred, you know?
I should bunk off college every Tuesday to go and get a tattoo done, and then when it came to taking the exams, I had to leave the company I was working for, because I just had never been to college, I'd just been getting tattoos every week, but that's how we were back then. Fucking hell, no one gives a fuck about anything. Tattoo studios years ago were just fantastic.
Yeah.
I mean, it was a barter system that existed, you know. People would come in and trade you things for tattoos. I mean, you know, it was a cashless society of its own making.
Yeah. Crazy
stuff. Mate, I used to have a guy called Colin the Anorak come in here. He used to come in, he was as skinny as a rake, and wear this big anorak. And then he'd go shoplifting and he'd come back and he looked like the big fat circus man, but it was just full of stuff that he'd nicked.
How many tats have you done for Dave Baby in the past?
Quite a few.
This up here. Filling little bits in.
Mm-hmm. Walking piece of art, sir.
Yeah, I did to this. This is Lal. Rapunzel.
Oh, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair. I kind of say to people, it's quite interesting that if you look at it now, there's more tattoo studios on Camden High Street than there were in the whole of London in 1980.
Yeah.
Which is pretty crazy to see that.
Yeah.
When I first started, it was pretty much traditional style and kind of westernized Japanese work, and then really the 1980s were really fast moving because of the different subcultures and the fact that loads of those adapted tattoos and motifs that were connected with that particular subculture. Then tribal tattooing came along, which was, you know, quite big at the time. dolphins were popular, kanji, you know, there's just been
So, right, please. you reckon the future is of tattooing and that?
It's quite interesting you say that, because there's so many fantastic artists, so many different styles, but I'm just...
Sorry,
mm-hmm.
Just top them in, please.
Just trying to work out whether there's going to be a kind of decline in it because everyone's got them, or if it's going to go stellar, go even... you know, more creative than it is. It's just like, just when you think stuff can't get any better, you just see new artists come along and just blow your mind. So it's, you know, it's definitely at its highest artistic way it's ever been, and the most people getting it done. So it's just hard to tell, you know, but it's interesting to keep an eye out and see how it is, you know.
It's great.
You're loving it, Dave.
Yeah.